Right here we have the snails. We're about to eat this. These are snails from the vineyard. Incredible.
Доброго ранку, everyone. This is David Hoffman from David's Bin here, coming at you from Berehovo, the wine capital of Transcarpathia in Ukraine. I am so excited. We're here right on the border with Hungary. And today what we're going to do is I'm going to take you to the best winery in the area, Cezai. We're getting a full tour of the property. We're going to try delicious wines. And then after this, we're going to be eating at an incredible Transcarpathian restaurant. What's the name of the restaurant?
Cezai Malahora.
Cezai Malahora? Yeah. That's the restaurant name?
That's the restaurant name.
Okay.
Transcarpathian and Hungarian food.
That's made up of a lot of pork. Okay, let's go inside Chateau Cezai. Mm-hmm. This place looks amazing. Woo! Freezing today. Hello, hello. How are you?
Nadia. Dobre. Fine, fine.
Fine, fine. So as soon as you walk into the winery, go to the right and you have the store, right? The gift shop. And they produce 25 different types of wines. Most unique one I've ever seen is this one. It's kosher wines. Never seen them before in my life. But they got Pinot Blanc, they have Pinot Noir, Ferment, Cuvée, right? Cabernet Sauvignon, Moscatel, right? Mm-hmm. So they have so many, and obviously there's like indigenous grapes from the area, but they also have international grapes. And over here, they have an old school barrel where, you know, people used to press the wine, and this is where you leave, you know, a little tip, but it also pays their salaries. Okay, let's go on a tour.
The whole territory where they keep the wine, store the wine, and they pour it in the bottles also. And this is the building called Chateau from 1995.
So next up we have the museum, right? Mm-hmm. So Chateau Cezai Museum, and it gives you information of the area, the different grapes, the history, you know, that goes into the winemaking in the region, right? So that's where we are, Transcarpathia. I love these. These are incredible. Wow, I want one of these to make into a, you know, a little spa. The beer spa, right? A wine spa. Beautiful place. The museum is one big room split up in four different sections. First one shows you the different wines they use. Second one shows you how wine is produced, right? The process of making wine over here. Then as you keep going, you see the history of wine in the area, you know, Hungary, USSR, you know, different pieces of history for this area, right? And then at the very end, we have the evolution of the logo. So it was Cezai, now it's Chateau Cezai. So that changed in 2018 from what I saw. Incredible. So, and over here we have some of the older wines they made. We have a lot of the different barrels they used in the past. And I'm ready to try a glass. Ice wine. At 9 a.m. No, I'm joking. It's 10:30 already. So next up, we're going to the wine cellar. And over here they have many vines. You can see the area is full of vineyards. We're going to see that later at the restaurant. The restaurant is surrounded by vineyards. Beautiful. This is not typical weather right now. It's supposed to be really hot and no rain.
272 hectares of private vineyards here, so the products are local only, nothing imported.
Please, wine reservoir.
This is huge. Woo! These are massive tanks.
48 tons.
Wow. Massive. And there's like 20 of them here. Look at this. Huge stainless steel tanks. Just incredible. Obviously, if they're making 25 different wines, you have to be able to store and produce a lot. What a huge spot. And over here they have, you know, some barrels. Oh, it smells great in here. This is incredible. This is why you come to this area, to see this. Don't come over here and not visit the spot. You have to.
Just imagine 2.5 million wine in the stainless steel tanks in the whole reservoir.
2.5?
Yeah.
So give me two. Here is where it's stored, it's aging. From here it goes to bottling, then they export and domestically, okay? Perfect. Cezai has many wines, but they also have a premium collection of wines, and those are aging wines since 2016. So they have over 150 barrels from American and French oak, and this is where they age their wine. So let me open this. No, I'm joking. No, it's too early, guys. I need some breakfast too. Now that we've seen the shop, the museum, the wine cellars. We're gonna go try some wines, wine tasting. Whew, it is chilly today. Oh my gosh. And this is the wine tasting room. Anybody can come and do this. There's two different levels, right? There's
classics, which can be suitable for kosher wine tasting, and it costs 145 hryvnias, so this is roughly like $6?
$6, exactly. Mm-hmm. And then the premium, which is what we're doing, which we get cheese, crackers, chocolate, nuts, and we're trying 8 different wines, and that's
how much? That costs $10.
$10, I mean, that's a great deal.
You can also go just for a tour, which will cost you only $2. Okay. Then you go and you buy the wine in their shop.
You can't come here and not drink the wine. Come on. Okay, so what do we start with? What are we doing?
Please tasting local wine. Chersegi. Dry white wine.
Chersegi. So this is a dry white wine. 2020, right? And this is from the Balaton area in Hungary. It's dry, it's nice, it's clean, it's easy to drink.
Easy to drink.
Okay, I like it. I'm really into the white wines of Southeastern Europe. I mean, it is very different. Obviously, the sun hits differently here. Wow, this is fantastic. And it's easy to drink, right? And not too fruity, just dry. Mm-hmm. So between wines, just have like a cracker, a cheese, whatever you want. It's basically neutral, right? Just a little bit of a palate cleanser.
Sakura Transcarpathian Rose Dry Wine.
So this is another young wine. The last one was young, you know, 2020. This is same, very young, rosé, really pink. I love the color. And you're saying Cake Franco?
Yeah, Cake Franco is the name of this type of wine in Hungary.
Perfect. Let's try it. Budjo.
Budmo.
Budmo.
Cream strawberry.
Mm-hmm. Very strawberry-ish. Nice, dry, fruity. Another great wine. Love the wines out here. They're easy to drink. They're so different. And you know, for us, you know, in America, we don't see a lot of Ukrainian wines, obviously, because they're not exporting too much over there or very hard to come by. But this is something you must try. You know, if you like wine, come to the Ukraine, come out here. This is the best region in the Ukraine for wine. But they also have wine in Odessa, so just know that. Fantastic. Wow.
Cabernet red wine dry.
So this wine comes from the best wine year ever recorded in history, 2018, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do this. Oh yeah, I love cabs. Oh, so good. Smooth, very bold wine. This is perfect with like a big steak. Here it would be like a nice pork, right? Oh wow. Smells great too. Easy drinking too, not so bad. Like it's not like crazy, you know, forte, right?
Moscato, semi-sweet wine, kosher traditional wine.
This is Moscato. I love Moscato. Originally from the island of Sicily, no? Sicilia. Oh, yeah. Sweet, always sweet. Oh, molto bom. So this is a Hungarian Moscato, like the variation of it. It's called Moscato Antonel.
Otonel,
okay. So good. I mean, it does have a flavor like Tokaj, right? Very similar. I take a bottle.
I love it.
It's so good. It's ridiculous.
Kosher traditional wine, red, blend, semi-sweet.
No, we have to say actually, like, how did you say? Mazel tov.
It's
a kosher wine.
Exactly.
Oh, very good.
Oh, wow. This is so different. This is like, it feels like dry, fruity, but same time, very like easy to drink. No? The cab, it's a bold. Like I said, like, you know, you need like a steak. This one I could drink it like any day. We're eating a lot of snacks. So what is this one?
Pinot Grigio with lime and mint.
So this is from their fruit collection. It has Pinot Grigio with lime and mint, semi-sweet. And this is the first one that they started exporting to the United States. Whoa, so different. So like you get the feeling of the Muscat, the sweetness, but then lime and mint just hits you.
Aftertaste of mint.
So different, okay, right? Okay. I've never tried a wine with lime and mint.
It's a good aperitif.
Yeah, great aperitif.
Wine, traditional Transcarpathian, rose Transcarpathian, dessert wine.
This is premium class wine, dessert wine. They give it to you in these amazing glasses. I love this, dessert wine glasses, right? Oh, it smells like port.
Cognac flavor.
Yeah, cognac flavor right away.
I
have to try a little more. This is like, this is my jam right here. How much for this bottle?
$15.
$15? Mm-hmm. I mean, that is incredible. That's my favorite so far. I'm a big sweet dessert wine. When I went to Portugal, port wines all day, but everywhere in Spain, France, and Italy, you can get dessert wines. They're so good. Like people say it's the best thing at the end. I think it's the best thing throughout the whole day. Oh, it's too good. It's like ridiculous.
Grape white blend.
So again, guys, this is like grappa, raki in Albania, you know. Super strong, but I like it. This, in the breakfast, this with coffee.
People call it here terkvianka.
Terkvianka,
yeah.
Why?
That's just the name for this 42 degrees strong distilled alcohol.
How much for this bottle now? $15 US dollars?
$10.
Less than $10 for this. And it's grape because it comes from grapes. That was absolutely incredible wine tasting here. Tried so many delicious things. I mean, they're so unique, you know, indigenous grapes from the area, obviously Hungary right next door, and then international grapes, but they do it with a twist, you know, having that lime, that mint, have that like type of like grappa raki. Just wow, mind is blown here. Look at this, today's getting better. Still running a little bit though.
Jakuyu!
Thank you. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Ukraine, Transcarpathian. She's I.
I'll see you next time.
She's too nice. Thank you so much. I bought 2 bottles of wine. Can't wait to drink them. Thank you. All right, it's time for some food. Transcarpathian food, and it's freezing. It's wet. What a beautiful day.
David, it's just 5 minutes drive and we are in a restaurant, Mala Hora.
Like we said, we're on the border with Hungary. Kidos is right here, only like nothing. 10-minute drive, we're in Hungary. Obviously COVID times, we can't enter right now, or I can't enter without a COVID test. A little more complicated. But yeah, so this is a small town. There's a historical center, city hall, cathedrals. That's basically it here, right?
Thermal baths is also your must after the wine.
So it's also the thermal bath capital of Ukraine, this whole entire Transcarpathia. If you want to come relax at one of these thermal bath hotels, you can do that. You go to the hotel, you pay for the night, plus you get access to the spa. You relax, you chill. We don't really have time for that. It's all good though. We're going to explore and eat more food, right? That's what I'm about. That's it?
Yeah.
It's like another chateau. Wow, beautiful restaurant. Behind it, we have a hill, and that's all vines, vineyard, wine country. We just came in the restaurant. Love it already. Right here to the right, you have the vineyards, right? Vineyards. We're going through the menu. Unfortunately, it's all in Cyrillic in Ukraine, right? But she's translating for me, so they have some Hungarian fish soup. They have snails from the vines. I mean, really exotic, different farm to table. That is the best. Farm to table. Obviously, we'll try some more wines here because we're in a vineyard. But yeah, I can't wait to eat. I'm excited. I'm like so hungry, and the food's the best here. I'm, you know, what can I tell you? I'm a little biased because my family's from the area. Hungary, all day. Magyar.
Oh. This is cool. Turkey and a white mushroom sauce. Good? Yeah. We haven't tasted it yet.
Time to enter the kitchen. Let's see what they're cooking up.
And right here we have the snails. We're about to eat this. These are snails from the vineyard. Incredible. So they're like stuffed with like butter. They're frozen. Then they bake them and it's gonna be amazing. Oh, it smells incredible.
So we've seen the chefs making salads, escargot, what else? She's got some stews, pork stew. We have the mushroom soup, which I'm gonna eat right now. We also have an incredible beetroot salad here. I think it's phenomenal. Like, I love coming to the back. In the back, my mouth starts to salivate. It's like, you see how they put love into making all this incredible food. Ukraine.
Food is freshly cooked, so he is keeping registers for every single preparation of the food that's done exactly on the day when the food is gonna be served.
What's that?
Snails from vineyards.
Okay, my friends, so we're starting off with snails from the vineyard. Wow. I'm just gonna dive in here. Escargot, right? Well, that's French, but for me, it's snails. With garlic. Bring me 10 more.
This is the salad of the restaurant with beetroot, greenery, and with pork, of course.
Can't stop with these incredibly delicious. They're small, but they are absolutely phenomenal. So like, what I would say is maybe pair it with bread if you want to. For me, I would have like 50 in a row. Bite size. Just you feel it going down.
They're not as big as in Belgium, but garlic.
This is a beetroot salad with pork, cabbage, and greens. It's like a mustard, honey mustard sauce. Nice dressing. Big cabbage guy. Love cabbage. If you come from this part of the world, you're all about the cabbage life, right?
The beetroot has something inside. It's not just simple beetroot. It's filled with something. I can't even say what it is.
So good. Yeah, beetroot, look at this. So it's like almost like red pepper, right? The sizes of it, the way they've done it. What a great salad. All about that salad life too. If you guys don't like greens, you're missing out, definitely, because here, this is some of the freshest greens ever. Right here, from the table, right? Everything. So crunchy. We had snails, we had salad. Now it's time for soup. Look at this. Oh. I personally love mushroom soup. The creamy. If you guys don't know, Transcarpathia was famous for their mushrooms. This entire area, the entire thing, like from Romania, Slovakia, Hungary, it's all mushrooms. And it's the white mushrooms. Wow, we saw them yesterday at the waterfall. So this is like creamy, it's earthy, oily. It's perfect for like if you had a hangover last night, have this. I can't stop. All right, last bite, and we're getting turkey. So good.
Has more mushrooms than cream. David, you're having the main course. This is the turkey and the white mushroom sauce with mashed potatoes. And to that you have Pinot Noir wine, which is the wine from a private winery of a famous Ukrainian folk singer, Oleg Skripka.
So turkey with mashed potatoes, you have some tomatoes and white mushroom sauce. Wow. Feels like Thanksgiving. Wow. It's so delicious. I mean, it's fresh turkey from the area. The mushrooms from right here as well. The mashed potatoes like super creamy and pasty. This is like a very heavy meal. This is like good for winter, obviously. Right now it's really cold. Tired of pork. It's good to like mix it up because when you eat pork like every day for like 7 days, it's a lot. One of the best dishes I've had in the Ukraine, this one. Wow. The whole thing is wow. And I thought this was like a rosé, but Pinot Noir, right? Light, not too sweet, very dry, a little fruity. I've never seen this before. Potato pancake with avocado, sour cream, arugula, and trout. That's trout.
Still super hot. You know, potato fritter here in Ukraine is more, I guess it's similar to like a hash brown in the United States, right? A little different. But this one is very unique because, you know, you have this super thick pancake, then you get the avocado, the sour cream, the arugula, and the trout. It's hot, it's cold, creamy, and the trout. Oh, you try with this one? Ferment, and this is from the other, from the winery we went to. This is from Chateau Chazay. Typical from the region. Every dish is phenomenal.
Delicious.
Super cold day, lots of food, good wine. You need some coffee to pick you back up.
I have good coffee here.
Quasi come gli italiani, espresso.
In my experience, I prefer the coffee which has a little of sour flavor. So even the hotel, which was very simple, had really exceptional coffee.
Boom. 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 Thank you. Love this restaurant. So good. The snails, escargot. And that is Berehevo, the wine capital of Transcarpathia. We started off at the number one winery in the area, Chateau Chizai. Just like this restaurant, Chizai.
Malahora.
Malahora. So we had lots of wine. We went through the store, the museum. We went down to the cellars. We did a wine tasting, tried like 8 different wines. They were all fantastic. I don't know, it's gonna be hard to beat that Moscat. That was so good. It was so sweet. Yeah, and people there are so, so friendly. Very hospitable. Thank you so much. Then we came here to Chazay Melaharo. No.
You're right.
Okay, yeah. I said it right. Yeah, so we went into the restaurant, went to the kitchen. Everybody's super friendly. We tried some snails, mushroom soup. What else? Turkey with...
Mushroom sauce and mashed potatoes.
I'm forgetting everything now. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're ever in the area and you like wine, come out here, explore, just like we did. This is like a half day tour. Start off at 10 in the morning. Right now it's 2 p.m. You can do it all very easily, really close to each other. And yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, thumbs up, comment below, subscribe to my channel for more awesome travel content. We'll see you in the next travel food adventure down here. Woo! In Transcarpathia, and it's cold and it's wet. Wow.